Welcome back, one and all. This is Artman Advance, bringing you more Let's Play Outer Wilds. In the last episode, we tried to go to the Tower of Quantum, on Brittle Hollow. That didn't work out because I couldn't tell one rock from another once it broke apart in the vastness of space, but I have an idea. Feel good banjo music, indeed. But I have an idea. We are going to go back to Brittle Hollow. We are going to put our little scout in there. And then I gotta find something to do while we wait for Brittle Hollow to break apart. There we go. Oh no, not Hollow's Lantern. I want to go to Brittle Hollow. Hey, Folly, thanks for stopping by. It's a thought that counts. Alright, there's the Equator. Perfect landing. I've actually gotten pretty good at that. Oh, South Pole. Classy. Okay, so we've made it to the equator. Now we just gotta find our way down. That lurk message makes me think of something another friend brought up. They had tried to unlurk on one of my streams, so maybe I should make a little entry for when somebody wants to unlurk. And I know it's slow going. I have, and I will admit, to procrastinating on my model because it's scary trying new things, but I at least have some progress. There we go. Alright, that's the gravity pad. I think I want to go down from here. Crossroads. Okay, so go back up and hit the crossroads again. I think this will take me about where I want to go. Before everything falls apart. Where are all the gates? This is where I want to go? Oh no, I just went into a big circle. Whoops. Okay. There we go. This is a different canon than the one on Ember Twin. Might be worth reading the readout. Okay. I get back there in time. And jump in 3, 2, 1. I know, that wasn't productive, but made me happy for a brief moment. Okay, I don't think I want to be down here. Those ruins, okay. It's right over the crossroads. Oh, okay. There's no way down from there, unlike this right here. This is actually where I want to be. I do believe. Let's put the scout there. In from here. Surface integrity is getting worse and worse. I would head back to my ship to restock my fuel, but I feel like I won't be able to get there in time. It's random based on where the meteors fall. Hey, I can see the surface from here. Doubt I'd have enough fuel to get to the surface. You can sabotage it by ramming the surface with your ship. Now, I'm not worried about the surface integrity of the planet. I'm worried about the surface integrity of the structure. Again, not much to do. I doubt I could get back to the ship from here and refuel. think I get what you mean by sabotage, though. I probably make this jettison out to space early. Yeah, I could probably make this jettison out to space earlier and give me more time to explore it if I just ram it with the ship. I think I'm making it to space at this point. I am running low on oxygen. I have next to no fuel. That's not gonna work. Thank you. Solanum, your arrival here means you've completed preparation on Giant's Deep and ready to depart for the Quantum Moon. On your pilgrimage, the Quantum Moon will carry you, just as it carried me and many in our clan before me, to the Moon's sixth most secret location. You'll be aided in your pilgrimage by the shrine our clan built on the Quantum Moon, but remember this final rule. To explore the sixth location, the shrine must be on the Moon's north pole. Be curious on your journey. There's the eye. Oh. Okay. No, this is some kind of marker that indicates where something is. Right now, it's on Brittle Hollow. I read that scroll, and by the time I get down there, yeah, I'm already done. I see it, though. Right. There. Yes, progress. That, and I found a way to cheese using oxygen as a propellant on that thing. Alright. Well, I found out one thing. Next thing is to check out Giant's Deep. I'm not gonna lie, I did look up a little bit before tonight's stream. And now I have an idea of what the game refused to tell me. Giant's Deep. I'm gonna try something stupid first. Didn't make it. Tells you just fine, you didn't go where the answer spelled out yet. Well, regardless, I do know one clue to be looking out for. Not that. There's Gabbro's ship. Different. Okay. We've made it to the core. I can finally make use of that hint that was given to me earlier by Feldspar. Yeah, if I can find any of the little blighters. Aha! make sure I get into the head. All right. In yet? Made it! We are inside! I just gotta figure out where this is. Or rather, its significance. Oh, there's a thing. The module that fell. Three masks. I have exciting news, Privet. The Ash Twin Project is almost prepared to receive the probe data from the orbital probe cannon. Raimi is adding some finishing touches here, but she'll be finished soon. Are you in the orbital probe cannon well? We are! The statue here in the probe tracking module is ready to record each launch's flight trajectory and will automatically transmit all relevant data to you. Once the probe determines the location of the Eye of the Universe, I'll send an alert directly to you and Raimi. On the other appendage, I'm now worried about this cannon's structural integrity and its crew's moral integrity. I mean, that's a mood, right? Oh, hello! Somebody's activated a statue here. Let's see what this has to say. Imagine, Privet, the probe tracking module will be the first to know the coordinates of the Eye of the Universe. You'll be the first to see them. I am honored and terrified. You won't ask the orbital probe cannon to use so much power that it breaks, will you? Fret not, my nervous friend. We only need to fire the probe once anyway, so who minds if it compromises the orbital probe cannon's structural integrity slightly? I would mind, Mallow. I would mind because we won't be capable of receiving our probe's data if the probe tracking module is destroyed. And guess what happened? See now, yeah, I get it. Let's What's this all about? Receiving data from probe 9,318,082. Visualizing current trajectory of probe 9,318,082. Retrieving previous launch data from Ash Twin. Total number of probes launched, 9,318,082. Deep space anomaly matching all known criteria for the Eye of the Universe found by probe 9,318,054. Retrieving stored coordinates from Ash Twin. Displaying coordinates for the Eye of the Universe. If only I could read that. L-A-N. Whoa, didn't mean to go that far. Dang it, I didn't mean to go there. Take a look at the first two again. After some number of shots ago. This is correct. We are on probe, we're on probe X-84, but probe X, no, X-82, but probe X-54 found what it needed to. Probe X-54 found it. And this is where it is. That's the White Hole Station. I wonder what that is. Oh, whatever. Oh, those are supernova. Never mind. Okay, then. This is gonna be fun. Been through exactly 32 loops. I don't know, actually. That is indeed the question. My ship's still in the same place, and I just need to find a jellyfish to hitchhike off of. I believe that's one. I can... I made it in. So what you're saying is the probe finds this thing on the first loop you ever play? Let's see, where's my ship? They're my ship. Or the loop before that. Oh no! This is a fine pickle. Believe me, I am trying my very hardest. Yeah, I did find something important. No, I'm not. That's a good question. Let's check the computer logs on what we've learned so far. Have I figured out what the symbol in the tower meant? No. No, I have not. There it is. LAM. Kind of. Yes, it has. The sun is not actually a planet. Looks like two of them made it out, but the third one did not. One of them made it to the Hourglass Twins. The third escape vessel is in the Dark Bramble. Yes, I do. Well, let's check the old settlement, I guess. Okay, not the old settlement. Let's see. The old settlement has more for me to look into, but... City. Was there more to explore there? There's more to explore here. Just north of Rybeck's camp, huh? Let's see if I can figure out what the game wants to tell me about the old settlement. Let's make our way to the old settlement. Settlement's gonna be down that way. Well, I deserve this. Zora. See if I can make it back to the old settlement without much issue. Now let's find our way back to where we were. Might as well top off at my ship since I'm here. Alright, so the old settlement. Hello. This is the old settlement. Knowledge is too dear to lose. Here's everything we can recall about the signal we encountered while aboard the vessel. The signal is older than the universe itself. No, my clan ever encountered anything. I think I've read all this before. What did I miss last time I was here? The signal is leading me right here. Is it this? Oh, there's something down there. Is there a way down there? Hello. There's the murals. Why did the vessel crash in that place? Was the vessel unwell? A signal. Destination. What is this? It says there's something else of merit here, but I'm not seeing it. Let's see. Give me a moment to think. That I'm missing. There's something. I can hear the other escape pods distress signals. Oh, that's sad. I guess. Alright, up we go then. And it just led me back the way I came. Something here. I have a guess as to what you've yet to explore, and it's near the roof of the settlement. Okay. So we want to go up then. For the settlement, huh? Not sure how we're gonna get to the roof of the settlement at this rate. At least not in this loop. Settlement. Now I just need to find a way to go up. Wait a minute, the Northern Glacier? What I missed. What the? They let go. Now I've got an idea of what I should be doing, and I missed my stop. Checking my my Twitch stream manager, and I think it's stuck on my last stream. Well, back to the ship. Let's see what we learned.
Ah, okay. Okay. Alright, okay, I see. Okay. Alright, where was this? Okay, yeah, this is on the Ember Twin. So that should be my next angle of attack, my next vector of exploration. The anglerfish fossil. I can either check the Ember Twin next, I can come back here on the next go-round and find the Hanging City. Ash Twin Towers. I have not explored the Ash Twin at all. Oh, and there's more to discover on the Northern Glacier. You know what? I'm here. Let's explore the Northern Glacier. Has anyone observed the phantom moon that sometimes greets us in the night sky? Your thoughts interest me. I compliment your eyes. How do you imagine it disappears? Hypothesis. Could it be a shift in the light spectrum? Suppose this moon is too shy to show us its face. I'm interested in your playful moon. Is it much like the violent friend Hollow's Lantern? This moon isn't volcanic to my unaided eyes. Sometimes it leaves its friend Hollow's Lanterns for nights at a time. The nights the moon circles this planet appear random. It seems to travel as it likes. Imagine if there were two volcanic moons. Then I imagine there'd be none of us left. Hypothesis. There can't exist too much lava. I strongly prefer we test the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis, eh? It is nice to have choices. Is this? Okay, this is melted ice. Quantum Moon. Know where that is. Interesting. All I gotta do is find the construction yard so I can find the Southern Observatory. Well, I mean, we're here. Alright, there's the observatory. Now I just need to find a way to get down into it. Let's see. There's gotta be some path that's still available. I don't know, we might be too far gone in this timeline. You know what? We only got so much time left anyway, I'm gonna YOLO it. There's a crack into the planet. Well, there is a way up from that surface. Paths underground from the tower and the cannon, but they're probably kaput with the planet apple cord. True. I did see a jumping in point, but I didn't have the thrust needed to get in there. This is the North Pole. I wanted to be at the South Pole. Ah, well. You can always get what you want 100% of the time. Made it. Oh well, nowhere to go from here. Oh, I see something. I mean, hey, didn't get much done in those last few seconds, but we did find some valuable information. Okay, we've got choices. Let's see which one sounds the best at this moment. The only reason I stayed on Brittle Hollow was because I had a few leads I could follow and I was still there. This is a fresh loop. Let's see what's in store. Right, I landed on the interloper once. It did not work out well. Ember Twin it is. Let's go see if we can find out what to do with that anglerfish. There we go. Now we just make our way to the Sunless City. Until you land on the interloper right before it drove into the sun. Okay. Next time I'll give it a look. So let's see where to go. Let's see if I can remember this. I don't think I ever knew where it was to begin with. Miss. Feed the fish the light, and it should lead you where you need to go, right? Okay, I fed the fish a light. So now... Oops. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, that's the overlook. Stepping Stone District is what I want. Okay, then. Whoever was it when we ended last time is the anglerfish. Rule change. The anglerfish now has to wear a blindfold and do not peek. Why are we changing it? It's too hard if you can't see anything. Aunt Pi says real anglerfish are blind, so you have to wear a blindfold. The rule stands. Rule update. It's okay if younger kids don't wear the blindfold when they're it. The rest of us will still wear it for scientific accuracy and to make the game more even. The rest of us, the little fish, line up against one wall. When the anglerfish says go, the little fish sneak across to the other side. If the anglerfish catches you, you're eaten. The last little fish to be caught is the new anglerfish. The old anglerfish gives the new anglerfish the blindfold and becomes a little fish. Okay, then. That was interesting. And there's something up there. The anglerfish is blind. Anglerfish study. Its anglerfish digestive tract suggests death by starvation. Visually, the specimen appears to be the same species as the anglerfish in Dark Bramble. We don't believe it originated from this planet. An update. Melray, while I was here making sketches of the anglerfish, I observed the children I saw earlier playing here again. They've added a rule to their game that incorporates our research. It's wonderful. I'm entirely delighted. It's never too early to appreciate biology. The long growth protruding from its head is bioluminescent. Perhaps it used this growth to attract prey? A lure? Well, that's interesting. So there was a shortcut there this entire time. They chase you, how are they finding you? Through noise? Oh, the door is broken on the outside. Okay. Vacate the premises. So maybe they won't kill you dead if you're silent. We're playing the fossil fish game tonight? Okay. Making it to the surface. There's a way out through the gravity room access. That was always open, okay. Real anglerfish are blind. Okay. I meant to back up, not exit out. You know what? I'm near the Ash Twin anyway. Careful, don't want to get caught in the sand stream. Okay, the ship is safe. Oh, that's no good. One of our own kind, mayhap? Big cacti. Hello. First delivery, Yarrow, one warp core fresh from the Black Hole Forge. Root is installing this core sibling on Brittle Hollow as I write this. My gratitude, Clary. With this, the Ash Twin project is underway. I confess, I'm deeply curious about what you and Poke found on the White Hole Station that started this project. Could I visit sometime to learn more? I recommend you do. The White Hole Station is the model for the towers being built for the Ash Twin project, so a visit to the station would be doubly useful. I suppose, more precisely, I would like to visit the White Hole Station with you, Clary. Arrow stops using the scroll wall to flirt with my sister. In romantic matters, her density rival a neutron star. I go meet her on the White Hole Station. I'd be happy to explain our findings. Oh, boy. Gotta love the way siblings talk about each other. careful about the sand.
Be careful about the sand!
Much of this planet left. Hop into the ship. I think I did. Black Hole 4. Go ahead and unmark that. Sun station. Well, we're here. The sun hasn't blown up yet. Key word being yet. Is this a sun station? That's convenient. Missed a couple things in the Hourglass Twin Towers. Alright, what is this I'm on? Oh, the planet's stripped bare now. Like a big version of the thing on the high energy lab. It does. So that could mean that no, that was not the sun station. Outside the blast radius, so this should be quick. I think next is going to be the Dark Bramble, see if we can't find escape pod number 3. Thank you. Let's see. Stress beacon. Yeah, I'm not letting autopilot cork me again. And slow. No need to rush. Found it. Try that again. found the third escape pod. Our escape pod crashed as we tried to flee this place, destroying our movement and communication capabilities in the process. We've held out as long as we could here, but this pod's supply of breathable air is nearly depleted and the anglerfish attack more and more frequently. Our best chance at survival is to return to the vessel to either repair the damage or, more probably, await rescue. Seka, is the message finished? The vessel's beacon is already growing fainter. It will be gone in a matter of hours. We need to leave here quickly. Okay, then. Begin flight log. Escape pod 3. Vessel has been mortally injured. Emergency sequence activated. Awaiting departure from vessel. Now launching escape pod 3. Multiple collisions have altered pod's trajectory. Significant damage to pod detected. Navigation error. Life support error. Propulsion error. Scanning external environment. Scan complete. Gravity not detected. Breathable air not detected. Multiple life forms detected. Potentially hostile. Verdict. Do not exit pod. Then, there's a new problem. Our equipment is detecting two distinct beacons from the vessel. Pardon me. But it isn't possible for the vessel to be in two different locations at the same time. I agree, but the beacons are exactly identical to each other. Perhaps if I had more time. We're nearly out of time already, Din. The vessel's beacon is quickly fading. Soon it will be gone and we will be lost. We will follow the beacon whose source is nearest to us. But suppose that beacon is false. Oh wait, we likely don't have enough air to reach the farther of the two beacons, Din. The decision is made for us. We'll leave a trail of lights as we go. There's still a chance someone can hear our escape pod's distress signal. Might want my ship. Right now I need to stay still. Alright. Let's slowly make our way back to our ship. How close that red glow is. All right. So, slowly and carefully, all of the lights. That's a lot of bodies I just noticed. I hit the book with my scout. I hate the dark bramble. Near the node. I see blue on it. Hold on. I think I see what you're talking about. No, I don't. I was staring right at it. Reflection of the light. Unless it's this bit on the flower? Then again, that's also just a reflection of the light. Or this thing. Ah, okay. Forgive me, the thing is tiny. To any who come here searching for us, we followed one of the two beacons from the vessel to this place, but now can go no further. It's almost too faint to hear now, but the vessel's beacon is still faintly emitting from within this thorny seed, yet the opening is too small for even a single Nomai to fit through it, so our escape pod couldn't have flown through here. I don't understand how this could be possible, but this gruesome place seems to be able to manipulate space itself. Maybe this was our undoing. To be so close to the location of the vessel and still so far is difficult. Worse, the vessel's beacon is dying. Soon we'll be unable to hear it. There's nothing we can do now but try to perhaps find a way inside, or at least attempt to comprehend why this happened. My dearest hope is that the other escape pods are able to reach relative safety. Where our scout is. Ah! This does not look good. The heart of the planet itself? Once you're through there, there's no fish in the next area. Good. This is it, the vessel. Morbidly beautiful as well. Okay, I need a way inside. I didn't realize that was a... Look, it didn't look like there was a way inside there. Okay. Oh, there are trees here. Okay, then. Marble. would it do? Warp core. Neat. Ooh. What is this? Not much time to explore. To any Nomai clans whose vessels can hear this message, it's clear the universe is dying. There are fewer and fewer resources and safe places within space now, so my clan and I believe the best option is for all of our clans to stay together. You can reach the gloaming galaxy. We found that Blackrock suns are fairly stable and life in this star system is comparatively thriving. We live in relative safety. If you prefer to continue exploring alone, know you will be on your own. But Canna, we're making our way to you. Good to hear from you, Bromi. We'll watch for your vessel. Anyone heard from Neem, his clan? Was on its way to our vessel, but they never arrived. He hadn't sent any messages, and I'm beginning to worry. That is unsettling. Reminds me of that. I'm not gonna finish this, am I? Reminds me of the old myth my grandfather used to tell, the disappearing of Escal. Remember hearing that story as a child. One day, Escal's vessel simply stopped responding. The other clan searched and searched, but found no trace. It's as if their missing friends had warped out of existence. Alright, well, now that I know where to find the ship, I can dedicate more time to actually exploring it. I mean, we still got plenty of time. I could probably check what that red light is all about. Got more sense than the autopilot. I guess let's follow the red lights. See what that's all about. Fear. They cannot see you. Slowly float forward. Eggs. Are they seeds? No, these have got to be eggs. Gold glow will lead you to the vessel. I think this could be the gold glow right here. It's just flying straight. and now the signal scope isn't working. Oh, hello. Had I known it was this simple. Thank you. the writing on the wall, quite literally. Here, maybe? There's something. I'm recording now. I've never encountered anything like this. The signal the vessel is receiving appears to be older than the universe itself. This is our first contact with anything of this nature. Everyone, prepare to warp immediately. Eskel, wait. I need more time to send an outgoing message. Shouldn't we tell another clan where we're going? We can send the message upon our arrival. This extraordinary signal appears suddenly. It may disappear just as quickly, and we can't lose a discovery this incredible. Focus on preparing for the warp instead. I understand. Anona, is the vessel ready to warp into the signal's approximate coordinates? Warp core is powered, but this will be a significant jump. After, we'll need time to recharge the core. That shouldn't create a problem, provided we arrive at or near the signal source. Everyone, we're ready to warp. There's the message. Hear from you. Has anyone heard from Neem? His clan was on its way to our vessel, but they never arrived and he hasn't sent any messages. I'm beginning to worry. That is unsettling. It reminds me of that old myth my grandfather used to tell, the disappearance of Eskel. I remember hearing that story as a child. One day, Eskel's vessel simply stopped responding. The other clan searched and searched, but found no trace. It's as if their missing friends had warped out of existence. That's no myth, friends. Eskel's clan existed, and their story was real. What a curious event to have passed into myth. Our ancestors' ancestors were told that story when they were young. Are you sure it's true, Hosup? It was a very long time ago, but yes, my clan's ancestors searched for Eskel's clan for a long time, but in the end, none of them were ever seen again. The only time in our history a vessel has ever disappeared in this way. Hyssop, I hope you weren't comparing Eskel's story to my clan's vessel. Neen, my friend, we feared you were gone. Not yet, we aren't, but nearly. We found trouble during our warp. The triple suns of the bright spark star system exploded, and it was only a lucky coincidence we weren't caught in the blast. We'll meet you soon, Kanna. I'm relieved your clan's safe, Neen. It's good to hear your words. Any vessels nearby, remember to be extremely cautious of potentially unstable stars. Which is most of them now. Ooh, more writing. This is Eskel's vessel. Something went badly wrong during our warp, and our vessel is mortally wounded. We need help as quickly as possible. Our vessel appears to have... Has it fused with the local environment somehow? There are vines that are now part of the vessel. It's been torn apart from the inside itself. We are abandoning our vessel. Any Nomai clans or spaceflight-capable species receiving this message, I implore you, we need your help. Is this thing broken? Can anyone hear me? Our vessel is dying. We need immediate assistance. That's no good. Okay. I don't know anything about this yet, so I'm going to explore the rest of the ship and see if I can gather any clues. Oh. I went the wrong direction. Whoops. Wait a second. How could I have gone the wrong direction? Go top off for now, and then we'll go mess with the... That's why everything looks backwards. I ended up upside down. Okay, not sure what to do with that just yet. Wait a second. It just came to me. With not any time to spare. To put in the symbols I saw for the center of the universe into this thing. With the warp core. The moment it came to me, the music started. Probably is. I have to find a new warp core, I guess. Yeah, that would help. Might have to find a spare, yeah. You know what? No sense in going back into the ship. See what I can see before oblivion takes me. Boom. So what now? That's a good question. Let's see what we've unlocked in our computer VidMe system. That's depressing. Warp core is long dead. Well, let's try to get onto the interloper. The sun first. I could try that. Let's see what we can find out on the interloper before it slams into the sun. I've got some time. What the hell? Anything else damaged when you decided to take a nap autopilot? Okay. Okay, nothing on the North Pole. Anything on the South Pole before I decide to check the equator? Supposed to be a frozen ship on this thing? Found it. I think. This is troublesome. It seems the comet wishes to submerge our shuttle in ice. If we stay on the surface too long, the shuttle may freeze entirely. Even if it did, couldn't someone call it back home to the gravity cannon on Ember Twin? Oh. Yes, but the exploration of the comet would be more difficult if we were without the shuttle until someone recalled it. Perhaps we shouldn't have landed on the dark side of the comet. Suppose one of us remained in the shuttle to keep it warm and continue monitoring the surface. This would be wise, I think, Clary. If you don't mind waiting here with it, Poke and I can continue to investigate the surface. Yep. Stay put. Oh no, my ship. And it's still here. I think. Just barely. Heal up, and what did I need to do here? Shuttle's equipment heard strange energy readings beneath the surface, a fissure in the ice on the sunward side. Okay, there should be a fissure somewhere around here. Aha! No, aha. What even is this? There's no fissure. Let's see. I need to be able to see the sun at all times where I'm looking. Nope. I thought there was a fissure in the ice on the sunward side. I was about to say, that was weird. See, a fissure in the ice. Comet is tidally locked, the same side always faces the sun. So I'm in the right vicinity. Where is the fissure that they're talking about? Need to have the sun directly overhead. So, right about here? So, this is what they were talking about, but I don't see any way inside. Do I just gotta wait here until the sun melts the ice? Kind of like the Ash twin? Oh. Okay. Neat. Is it even going down? Kinda, sorta? I was too far away on the first pass, got right back as it closed up again. As long as my ship's on this planet, that's all that really, or this asteroid, that's all that really matters. Go and restock on oxygen real quick. Oh, there it is. Direction was it again? Over this way. Looking for a way into the comet. Wait, is it going back up? No. Aha! There's something. My ship's probably gone now. Surprisingly, no. I guess I landed in just the right spot. Thank you. receiving much stronger energy readings now that we're beneath the crust. Whatever it is must lie somewhere below, close to the comet's center. I'm starting to think it's more dangerous than we realized. Clary, can you hear us? Yes, but your voices are faint. I fear we will lose communication entirely if you continue any deeper. Keep the shuttle warm for us, Clary. We'll return the moment we identify the source of the energy readings. I understand, but be cautious, both of you. Not going that way. This way seems safe. That's not safe. Thankfully, I don't need to go there. Or I hope I don't need to go there. Okay, I'm gonna do this quick and get it over with. Cowabunga! Okay, not quick enough it seems. Oh well, I'll know better next time. I don't think I'm gonna get much more done. Let me check what's on the, if we unlock anything new. Anywhere covered in ghost matter is 100% fatal. Find another. Alright, let's check the logs real quick before we decide to... Before we decide who we're gonna raid. Ruptured core. I found the two missing members of the Nomai shuttle crew near a large ruptured stone that looks like it exploded from the inside. That's where all the ghost matter crystals came from. Well, I know what we're gonna do next time. We're gonna jump on the interloper and try to do that right. For those watching on YouTube, don't forget that I have a Bug Fables. I think we're going to be doing the Bug Fables finale next Saturday. I might have plans for an Animal Crossing stream tomorrow. I will see if circumstances allow it. And next Monday is Mega Man Battle Network 5 Kernel Edition. Those of you on YouTube, this has been Artman Advance. I thank each and every one of you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.